Dear friends, this is Prithviraj from Bangalore connecting with you once again through this short message on the model prayer. In Luke 11:1, we read that after Jesus finished praying, one of his disciples asked him to teach them how to pray. In response to his request, Jesus taught them a model prayer that we read in Luke 11:2-4 and Matthew 6:9-13. The appearance of the phrase "when you pray" few times in the context conveys that his people are expected to have the habit of praying. Praying is not an option but an obligation for the followers of Jesus Christ. We are called the people of prayer. The worship place of God is called the house of prayer. Prayer is something that every one of us can do. Our Father in heaven identifies with the relationship we can have with our Creator and the ruler of the universe. Father is a wonderful word picture highlighting the kindness and love of God. It conveys that He is near to us though He is in heaven. God is not only majestic and holy, but also personal and loving towards us. He is both transcendent and immanent. In prayer, we can approach God as a loving Father and not as a distant deity. This model prayer provides us a pattern for prayer. This prayer is not a selfish prayer. It doesn't have request for our individual needs alone, but also for the needs of others. The prayer has two main divisions. The first three requests are concerned with God's expectation on us, and the next four are the requests concerning our physical, mental, and spiritual needs. The first part conveys to us that we are to pray for the fulfillment of God's plan in our lives and in the world. In this prayer, we are taught to pray for God's will to be done and not our desires. The implications of the model prayer is the glorification of His name through us, extension of His kingdom in our life, execution of His will in our life, our dependence on God for our daily needs, seeking forgiveness for our sins and seeking His protection from the trials and temptations. The purpose of acknowledging God's name as hallowed or holy is that God might be glorified among us and be treated with the highest honor in our words, thoughts, and deeds by submitting ourselves to His Lordship. By praying that His will would be done on earth, we are surrendering ourselves for the execution of God's will in our lives, in our family, in our church, in our ministry, and in our country. Like Jesus, we have to submit to the will of the Father in everything that we do. Give us our daily bread, teaches us to ask God for the things we need in our daily life. We can depend on God to provide for our present and future physical and spiritual needs. Forgive us our debts as we also have forgiven our debtors, teaches us to confess our sins to God and turn from them, and also to forgive others as God forgives us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one is a request for help in achieving victory over sin and a request for protection from the attacks of the devil. We are asking God to help us to recognize temptation and to give us the strength to overcome it. This model prayer teaches us that we can approach the Holy God and ask Him to provide for our physical and spiritual needs, forgiveness of sins, and divine deliverance from the evil one. May we be encouraged to keep this as a model prayer in our life. Thank you for listening. God bless you.